Museums present a story that creates a connection between the person viewing and the object being viewed. That connection is what makes museums such an important part of communities all around the world. Museums can motivate people to want to learn more and can even inspire career paths. In my case, visiting art and history museums has had a major influence on me, and there's one experience in particular that I'd like to talk about today. But first, let me back up a bit. I did not grow up religious. My mother is Jewish and my dad is Catholic, but neither one practices. So in my family, we always celebrated the major religious holidays in a very secular sense. We light the menorah at Hanukkah. We put presents under the tree at Christmas. We eat matzo ball soup during Passover, and we decorate and hunt for eggs for Easter. But that's about it. Because my family is not religious, I was never very connected to my Jewish heritage. I always felt distant from that part of myself, but from a fairly young age, I wanted to explore more. When I turned 7, many of my friends were getting American Girl dolls, and of course, I wanted one too. For those of you who have had American Girl historical dolls, you may remember that they are all fictional characters from real historical eras. Of all the historical dolls, the one who appealed to me the most was Rebecca Rubin. Rebecca was a Jewish girl from New York City growing up in 1914. When we learned about Rebecca's story, my mom told me that Rebecca was just like my great-grandmother, who, like Rebecca, was born in New York City at the turn of the 20th century and grew up in a close-knit Jewish community. I liked that I could identify a little bit with my American Girl doll. Fast forward to 7th grade, where for an independent reading project, I chose to read Elie Wiesel's Night, which documents Wiesel's experience at the infamous concentration camps Auschwitz and Buchenwald during World War II. I chose this book for a couple reasons. First, although thankfully none of my direct ancestors were sent to concentration camps, many of them experienced anti-Semitism at various times. So I did feel some connection to Wiesel's story. Second, I chose to read Night because I knew that I would soon be visiting Auschwitz as a part of a family trip to Eastern and Central Europe. Auschwitz, located in Poland, was established in 1940 and became the largest of the extermination camps where Nazis murdered European Jews as a part of their final solution to the Jewish problem. Birkenau, nearby, was part of the Auschwitz complex. Ultimately, over 1.1 million men, women, and children were murdered at Auschwitz and Birkenau. Today, Auschwitz and Birkenau are historical sites that are preserved as both a museum and memorial. Memorials are meant to honor and convey emotion. Museums are meant to educate. Our tour guide led us through the experience that the concentration camp victims underwent, from the train ride where they were separated from their families, to the horrible sleeping and working conditions, to the death wall where people were led to execution, and the gas chambers where several hundred victims could be murdered at once. All of these experiences were incredibly emotional, bringing some on our tour to tears. At the same time, this visit taught me so much more about the Jewish experience during World War II than I could have known from reading about it in a book. This is the impact museums can have. Museums preserve history and present history, and in doing so, create connections for individuals and even communities. You can play with a doll, you can read a book, but a museum is a tangible, experience that inspires, educates, and creates lasting connections. And I experienced this firsthand. Thank you.